taking action for you tonight. A team in a local youth football league concerned that their season was over even before it started.
This really is an amazing story. They were told they couldn't use any football fields in the Butler School District for games, couldn't even use them for practice. Imagine that. That was until they called Channel 4 Action News.
That's right. So Channel 4 Action News reporter Keith Jones took action, helping them reach a compromise with the school district.
And these kids just want to play football here at the Butler area school grounds. Check out these letters and emails sent to the superintendent by parents this morning. One theory is to turn this softball field here into a gridiron. But there's a catch.
Tornadoes!
A brand new football squad. You've got your helmets, check, jerseys, they've got them. Now how about a field?
I know a lot of parents flooded the school district with phone calls to the point that they stopped accepting calls.
Parent Jessica Thomas says the school district didn't have any football fields available for three Saturday games.
Our facilities are used constantly, and all of our coaches have the option if they want a Saturday practice. The facility has to be there for them to do that.
Superintendent Dr. Edward Fink offered up two elementary school fields, but parents said it was mostly rocks and dirt. Thomas called us for help, and we took action.
I myself took upon the call for action and contacted you in hopes that you would be able to help us help the kids.
Yeah, and sure enough, I guess I put in a call. Turns out everything was compromised.
Yes, yes, it's amazing how things work.
Thank you.
The superintendent agreed that they could play their games on this softball field, but there's a catch. When the home run fence is removed, it'll expose several metal holes in the ground. Holes that will need covering.
And as you can see, everywhere there is a post, there will be one of these caps in place.
The school district is requiring the team to have an insurance liability policy before taking the field. Dr. Fink says it'll be up to the parents to watch these caps during the game.
And that's what we've agreed to monitor to make sure that that will not, you know, come to the surface in any way. So we'll make sure that we know that, the officials know that, et cetera, that won't be a concern anymore.
Okay. And Haley told me they'll start using this softball field the first three Saturdays in September. In Butler County, Keith Jones, Channel 4 Action News.